Father Moses. What time did you start? You started at 10:05. You know? But none of these answers are actually accurate. You know, the liturgy that we participate today is the same mystical supper that Christ officiated 2,000 years ago. It's the same supper. What time is today's liturgy happening? Today's liturgy is really actually happening outside of time. We think that it's happening at 10 a.m., but once the liturgy starts and we sing, "Blessed is the Kingdom," we have now traveled outside of time. We're participating in the same liturgy from 2,000 years ago. Well, where is it taking place? Here in Ann Arbor? No, once the liturgy begins, it's like the church is elevated above the earth, and like mystically, we are serving together with all those who are in paradise. The angels are present, the saints are present. You know, there's those contemporary, some of the contemporary elders and saints of Greece who talked about the fact that saints would show up at the liturgy and basically begin to concelebrate the liturgy, be standing on their side at the liturgy with them. I can't remember who it was, but it was one of these Greek elders, and at the end of the liturgy, he would commemorate not only the saints of the day, but he would commemorate the saints who had been serving with him that day. And of course, we say during the entrances, you know, that we are upborne by the angelic hosts, that the angels are present with us in the great entrance of the divine gifts. Obviously, there are many saints who have seen this. And then, who is serving the liturgy? Well, you think, oh, it's you, Father Moses, but like, it's not me, actually. I mean, technically, on one hand, of course, you know, we know I am serving, but on a much deeper level, it's really Christ serving in me. It's really Christ present, consecrating the gifts. I, of my own self, have no power to consecrate the gifts. Right? But it is Christ actually living and moving and being within me, and his priesthood being upon me. It's him mystically present, which is consecrating the gifts. Saint Sophroni of Essex, he talks about the fact that one time after I believe he had been in like a deep state of prayer, he went into the liturgy, and he said, as I was chanting in the liturgy, he said, I distinctly knew that it was not me chanting the liturgy, but it was actually the presence of the Holy Spirit living within me that was actually bringing forth all of the chanting in the liturgy. All of the petitions were basically streaming forth from the presence of the Holy Spirit dwelling within me. You know, I had a close friend, a fellow priest, who said that one time he went to a monastery, and he said he was serving there. And they gave him the vestments of the elder who used to be at the monastery. And he said he began the liturgy was whatever, he said, you know, whatever normal liturgy, over an hour or something. And he said, I experienced the whole liturgy as though it were 5 minutes. He said, blessed is the kingdom. I entered into a deep state of grace and prayer. And he says, I like lost track of all time. He conveyed all this to me. Because he was quite astounded by it all. And he said, I was outside of time. I was outside of time mystically, and then it was like the liturgy ended. And of course, we have countless examples from the lives of the saints and holy elders of seeing the uncreated light descend upon the gifts and transform them. All of these things happen in every single liturgy. And the early Christians were so close to death, and they were so fervent in their supplication to God, that they would serve the liturgy 4 days a week, Wednesday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Every week they would be serving the liturgy 4 days a week, because they were so enamored in the love of God and the desire for God to keep and sustain them. I read something recently, it was from a bishop, and I don't know the bishop, and I'm not speaking ill of him, but he was speaking about the fact that in old times, pious people would go long periods of time without communion. And this may have been true, that they were pious and that this happened, but this is not the historical norm. Neither is it normative. In fact, even on Mount Athos, which is quite interesting, the monks would often go long periods without communion. Well, the one who really changed that in the 20th century was St. Joseph the Hesychast. He had his brotherhood communing at least 3 days a week. And this was scandalous to people, that they would commune. Saint Nicodemus of the Holy Mountain. You know, participation in the divine liturgy is what lifts us out of the doldrums, out of the futility, out of almost the kind of nihilistic world that we live in. The liturgy mystically takes us up into paradise. We commune of heavenly things just by being in the divine liturgy. We participate in the grace of God which is showered upon us during the liturgy. And it's this mystical supper that we see instituted today, 2,000 years ago, that we are still celebrating today, that we are still actually participating in today. It has never come to an end. Later on, the gifts will be consecrated, and right prior to it, we'll say, "Take, eat, this is my body which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Do this for the remission of sins." This whole dialogue harkens back to the mystical supper because it's not harkening back in the present tense. Mystically, despite the priest, whoever that may be in this particular instance, it's myself, despite the great infirmity, spiritual weakness, and even you could say idiocy of the priest, at least when I'm speaking to myself, I can say this. None of the graces withheld from the gifts. Christ is mystically present in the priesthood. Christ is mystically serving the liturgy today for us, and in every liturgy, so that we may eat of his body and drink of his blood, that we may be united to him, that we may partake of heavenly things, and so be detached from the things of this world. To our God be all glory, honor, and worship, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, Lord, have mercy. světě amerikánského, ta pomeněmo svoj Bůh v Carství svojem všim dádení prísnej vojdy kdybou.
This land, those who serve in seats of civil authority and the armed forces, may the Lord God remember in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto age of ages. May God protect the Russian land and its Orthodox people, both in the homeland and in the diaspora. May the Lord God remember in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto age of ages. The sick, the suffering, the poor, the needy, those who have asked us to pray for them, unworthy though we be. Those who are unable to be with us with a worthy cause, may the Lord God remember his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto age of ages. The Orthodox departed this life, who lie here and everywhere, may the Lord God remember his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto age of ages. You and all Orthodox Christians, may the Lord God remember his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto age.
Amen. Ascended into the heavens and seated at the right hand of the Father.
sanctify those who love the beauty of thy house, glorify them who remember the divine power, the sacred knowledge who are hope in thee. Give peace to thy world, to thy churches, to thy priests, to all those in civil authority, to all thy people. For every good gift and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from thee, the Father of lights. And unto thee do we send up glory, thanksgiving, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord from henceforth and forevermore. Blessed be the name of the Lord from henceforth and forevermore. Blessed be the name of the Lord from henceforth and forevermore. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. In the Lord shall my soul be praised. Let them be here and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord and he heard me, and delivered me from all my tribulations. Come unto him and be enlightened, and your faces shall not be ashamed. This poor man cried, and the Lord heard him, and saved him out of all his tribulations. The angel of the Lord will encamp round about him that fear him, and will deliver them. O taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man that hopeth in him. O fear the Lord, O ye his saints, for there is no want in them that fear him. Rich men have true for the hungry, but they that seek the Lord shall not be deprived of the vain with thee. Come ye children, hearken unto me. I will teach you the fear of the Lord. What man is there that desireth life, who loveth to see good deeds? Keep thy tongue from evil, and thy lips from speaking up. Turn away from evil and do good. Seek peace and pursue it. The eyes of the Lord are upon the righteous, and his ears are opened unto their supplication. The face of the Lord is against them that do evil, utterly to destroy the remembrance of them from the earth. The righteous cried, and the Lord heard them, and he delivered them out of all their tribulations. The Lord is nigh unto them that are of contrite heart, and he will save thy humble spirit. Many are the tribulations of the righteous, and the Lord shall deliver them out of them all. The Lord keepeth all their bones, not one of them shall be broken. The death of sinners is evil, and they that hate the righteous shall do wrong. The Lord will redeem the souls of his servants, and none of them will do wrong that hope in him.
Blessed the Lord be upon thee, for his grace and love toward mankind, always, now, and ever, and unto the age of ages.
Amen.
Glory to thee, O Christ, God, our hope. Glory to thee.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Father, bless.
May he who showed us the most excellent way of humility, when he washed the disciples' feet and condescended even to the cross of burial because of his exceeding goodness, Christ, our true God, through the prayers of his most pure mother, of our Father among the saints, beds of the grave, Archbishop of Caesarea and Cappadocia, of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for he is good and loves mankind.
Amen. Our great Lord and Father is holy, is Gabriel, Patriarch of Moscow and of Russia, and our Lord the Fairy Master and Delorean, Metropolitan of Eastern America and
God, that thou hast not rejected me a sinner, but hast vouchsafed me to be a communicant of thy holy things, I thank thee that thou hast vouchsafed me, though unworthy, to partake of thy most pure and heavenly gift. But, O Master, lover of mankind, who for our sake didst die and didst rise again and didst bestow upon us these dread and life-giving mysteries for the well-being and sanctification of our souls and bodies, grant that these may be given unto me for the healing of both soul and body, for the converting of everything hostile.
Substance together with my bones, and line my five senses, and down the hall of me with thy fear, ever protect, preserve, and keep from every soul corrupt in the inward, purify and cleanse and adorn me, make me comely, give me understanding and enlighten me, show me to be the dwelling place of thy spirit alone, and no longer the habitation of sin, that from me as thine abode to the entry of communion ever, every evil doer, every passion may flee as from fire, as intercessors I may offer unto these all saints, commanders of the bodiless host, and forerunner of the wise apostles, mother, thine undefiled, pure mother, whose entreaties do thou accept, O my compassionate Christ, and make thy servant and child of light, for thou alone art our sanctification, O good one, in the radiance of our souls, unto thee as God and Master, we all send up glory as me every day. My joy, I thank thee that thou hast vouchsafed me, who am unworthy to be partaker of the most pure body and precious blood of thy Son, who thou who gavest birth to the true light, to thou enlightened the spiritual eyes of my heart, thou who gavest birth to the source of mortality, revive me, who am dead in sin, thou who art lovingly compassionate mother of the merciful God, have mercy on me and grant me and contrition in my heart, and humility in my thoughts, and the recall of my thoughts from captivity, and vouchsafe me unto my last breath, to receive the condemnation, sanctification of the most pure mysteries, the healing of both soul and body, and grant me tears in repentance and confession, that I hymn and glorify thee all the days of my life.
the blessing of glorious art thou of the ages. Amen. Now lettest thou servants accord peace, O Master, according to thy word. For my eyes have seen thy salvation, which thou hast prepared before the face of all people, in light of revelation from the Gentiles, and glory of thy people, Israel. Holy God, holy mighty, holy Lord, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy Lord, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy Lord, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, from now and ever, to the ages of ages. Amen. O most holy Trinity, have mercy on us. O Lord, blot out our sins. O Master, pardon our iniquities. O Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for thy name's sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, from now and ever, to the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heavens. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us out of temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
For thine is the kingdom, the power, the glory of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the age of ages.
Holy God, Mary, Father, and of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for he is good and Lord.